For Alexander and Valeria, there's no better place in all of Moscow, even in the rain. Gorky Park is in the center of the Russian capital, and it's at the heart of countless stories.
I proposed to her here when we were ice skating.
Oh, that's right. I forgot.
Gorky Central Park of Culture and Leisure, as it's officially known, has just turned 90. The park has 26 million visitors every year and has long become part of the fabric of people's lives here in Moscow.
It's an absolute classic for dates, to meet here for a walk, look at the swans, and imagine that everyone is as loyal as them. Then be disappointed they aren't, have a hot dog, and go to sleep on your own. When I was a kid, I used to go for walks here with my mother. Once we took a dip in the fountain. We put our feet in the water. It was fun.
The museum in the park shows how it all began in 1928. Gorky Park quickly became known around the world as a symbol of socialism. It was part of the Soviet drive to create a new athletic ideal, even a new man.
When Gorky Park was founded, the park showed off the epitome of Soviet lifestyle. Moscow's population of 3 million people lived in humble and sometimes difficult conditions at the time, in workers' dormitories. But here, there were sports grounds and clubs for popular Soviet games like chess and checkers. You could play volleyball, basketball, all the ball games.
Sports and activities are still a big part of park life. But after a huge revamp in 2011, the park has also become a symbol of a transformed modern Moscow. It was part of the Soviet vision for a city of the future, and 90 years later, Gorky Park is still the park of the people.